Different. What's up, everybody? It's your boy Slim, aka Mr. Different Beck, with another video. Today we're gonna be looking at how I record in FL Studio and also how I merge my tracks together, because I do the punching in, punch out technique when I'm recording artists and recording myself like that. I think it just gives you a better type of like a better take when you're doing music, especially it's good for people who freestyle or people who can't one take it, like, you know, Drake and all that shit. But, you know, I'm gonna show you guys how I record in FL Studios, because a lot of you guys been asking that. And like I said, we're getting to a recording month, so, you know, let's start by how to record. So first off, you know, it doesn't matter what DAW you use, you can still use these techniques. It just might be a little bit different in certain DAWs, so, you know. But I'm giving you a general overview of basic techniques to keep in mind when you're using these techniques, and also how to exactly record FL Studio. Now, there's many ways to record FL Studio. One way is to use Edison, and another way is to record inside of the playlist, which is just the playlist. I like to record inside the playlist because I feel like it's a whole lot easier to do than using Edison. But if you like to use Edison, you can definitely record into Edison and drag it into Edison. Perfectly fine. Whichever suits your boat is better. I'm definitely going to talk about the playlist this time. Another video I'll do one about Edison recording. If you guys want me to do that, I'll do that. So first off, you want to make sure you have everything set up right. Your microphone, your interface, all that. But mainly your audio interface. You want to make sure your audio interface is set up correctly for recording. Now, one thing to keep in mind, this is my audio interface. I'm using the Sapphire 24 Pro. It's a DSP version, so it has built-in effects in it. It has compression, EQ, and reverb built into it, which I don't use normally, but I can. One thing you want to keep in mind when recording is your buffer size. Now, when recording, you want it as low as possible, as low as your computer can handle. The lower the buffer size, the less latency you'll have, meaning the less time it take the sound to go into your DA, into your audio, going through your microphone, into your interface, and then go through your DAW and back out through your headphones or speakers or whatever. So the lower your setting, the less of the delay you have. The higher the buffer setting, the more of a delay you get, but the more processing power you can essentially have, because your computer's not working as hard. Meaning if you're mixing, keep a high buffer size, but when you are recording, keep as low as possible. If you can, go as low as, you know, as low as you can. Like, I usually record within 128 to 64 buffer size, depending on what I'm doing. 256 is good. When you start going past like 512 and up and stuff like that, higher than 256, you start hearing noticeable delay. So do keep that in mind if you want to, if you're recording, and the artist will notice that. But luckily my interface has a built-in monitoring system to where it does like low latency direct monitoring, so I can hear like I can hear spot on as I'm recording, like right now I'm using it right now, so I don't have to use FL Studio to monitor my recording because I can use my interface. And most DAWs had that. I know all Focusrite interfaces had that. My Steinberg interface had that when I used to have that. And I mean, nowadays they did have like a direct monitor input. Just, you know, figure out your interface, do that. So, but your buffer size does play a part about keeping, you know, being on time and all that too. So lower for recording, higher for mixing. So now that's out the way, we'll get into the part about recording, because that's just a little overview. So first, like I do, I like to leave my first channel for recording. My first channel is always gonna be for recording. Like, I don't use this channel for nothing. Like, when I'm doing mixing all that, I use that for if I'm recording. So what you want to do is go to your mixer channel, the number one. You want to go to your input. Now, depending on your audio interface or whatever, I'm using ASIO Link at the moment. So usually I would use my Sapphire, and it'll have like Sapphire 1-2 through whatever, through like 24 or something like that. But since I'm using ASIO Link, so you can hear my audio playback and all that good mess, I am, you know, doing this. But I'll use my input one, because input one is basically my first input, and I gotta link it together real quick. And now you should be hearing like a little echo double effect right now. So we'll go ahead and mute that. So we'll just turn that off right now. So once you do that, you'll get that echo and double effect. And a lot of people are asking, how do you remove that echo effect? Say you don't want to use FL Studio to monitor your recordings. How do you remove that? Simple. You just go right here, click this button right here, turn it off, unlink it, and there you go. Now FL Studio is still recording audio, but it's not monitoring that audio. So if you're using your interface for it, now you can have, you know, you can monitor without it monitoring. But as you can see, it is recording audio, because as you see, the meters are jumping up and down, blah 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 blah. You see that? So that's good. Now, what would you use? Why would you monitor your audio with FL Studio? Say you want to use FL Studio to monitor. Say you want to add effects to your voice, like auto-tune, or you want to see what a reverb sound like, or a compression setting sound like. If you're doing stuff like that, you want to, you like artists like to record with plugins, you would use FL Studio to monitor. But if you're not doing that, don't worry about it. Just turn it off. Like I said, FL 11, you just click it, unlink or whatever. Then FL 12, you just hit the triangle and it goes away. So and I think anything below FL 12, you know, you just hit the right, you right click and something like that. I forgot, I ain't used FL 11 so long. I'm so used to 12, so bear with me. But yeah, basically the same concept. Now I'm ready to record pretty much. So usually when you hit record, it will when you hit the record button, it'll give you like a list of things to do. I set mine to all, and I hate to never ask me that again because I just got tired doing it. But right now I got it set. You want to set it to the playlist, so you'll make sure it's on the playlist, so it records directly into the playlist. And yeah, and you, once you hit play, it's gonna do a countdown. So let's just do a little test recording real quick, and you can see how I record. So. Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Slim, aka Mr. Different. You already know, not motivated by the money, but the like, subscribes, and views. This is a test recording, and I hope I fucked up. Who cares? Let's do it. Boom. There you go. Now it's recorded right to it. If I press play, if I turn off the record, press play. Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Slim, aka Mr. Different. You already know, not motivated by the money, but the like, subscribes, and views. This is a test recording, and I hope I fucked up. Who cares? Let's do it. And you can put it to whatever channel you want to. Like, I'll put it on channel 2, blah, 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 that good stuff like that. And there you go. Simple recording, easy peasy. No, nothing hard to do right there. Now, let's say you're doing multiple tracks, or you're doing punching in, punching out. How would you go about that and doing, you know, punch in, punch out recording? Let's just do another example. I'll just delete this one. We'll just come on, do it. And we'll do another recording real quick.
Yeah, it's your boy Slim, a.k.a. on the mic. I don't really care. Y'all already know my rhymes be tight.
All right, we'll say that's the first. We'll say that's the first recording, okay? So we'll leave that alone. Next, we'll go. We'll just do another recording. So we'll just punch in right here.
Okay, y'all already know my rhymes be tight. And I keep it 100, man. You know I'm all right.
That's just some bullshit recorder right there. So how can we make these one track now? Let's make these one, like one continuous track. So first off, you want to zoom in and you want to kind of, you know, get rid of the access you don't need. You know, you make it, clean it up a little bit. You know, dress your tracks up, everybody. You know, dress your tracks up. You know, you can get like a little bit, I go like farther in some steps and kind of, you know, dress your track up a little bit. Make it look nice. Make it look nice. All right. Now we're going to send these both to a channel. So we're going to send them both to channel 2. And then when channel 2 is highlighted, you go to the little triangle right here. Go down. Go to record, render to wave. Is it disc recording? Go to render to wave or alt R. Hit that. Go to full song or whatever. You hit full song. Bit depth. Don't worry about that because, you know, you can do 24-bit. 34-bit, it's a 24-bit file, but it's going to be wrapped in a 32-bit. Floating point wrapper, but still gonna be a 24-bit fast. Don't worry about that. Hit full song. That's what we're gonna do. We hit start. And it should have had. Do it again because it didn't do it right. 1, 2. Boom. Oh, yeah. Boom. Make sure I did it right. Full song, leave remainder. Yes, there you go. So you gotta, my bad, you gotta make sure that it is armed. If you don't have it armed, it won't do it. So that's all you do. Now you have both of these takes in one take. And like I said, you can delete these two takes if you want to, but as you can see, if I mute them.
Yeah, it's your boy Slim, a.k.a. on the mic. I don't really care, y'all already know my rhymes be tight. And I keep it 100, man, you know I'm all right.
And see, that just makes it all one track, and now you got a cleaner session. So remember, when doing that, you want to send them both to whatever channel you want to go to. You want to arm the track. You want to click the little triangle, go to disc recording, and render to wave, and that'll make it one track. And then, like I said, you can just delete these. Just delete these two tracks. Send this to track number 2, and there you go. Now you got one take. And that's how I record. Like I said, I like to do the punch in, punch in, punch out method of recording. Like I said, it's easier and it just makes it a whole lot better than having to go back and forth through trying to do it in one take. Like, but some artists like doing that. That's them. But me, I don't. So I guess that's pretty much it. But I also will show you guys recording in Edison as well, which is basically the same thing. So we'll just bring up a copy of Edison real quick. Why not? This video is not long enough, so let's make it long enough. We're going to do it again. We're going to set the input to input one, link it up, and then we're going to take that away. So now we see Edison is recording as we speak. I like to do, you can do on input or on play. It doesn't really matter, however you feel is necessary. You can do it on input. I'm doing on play because if you're playing with the track or whatever, and you just hit play and it'll actually record. You hit aim it, but it's not recording until you actually hit the play button up here. So that's a good thing if you want to keep that way. One thing about Edison you have to remember when recording is whatever is behind Edison, it will record. So if you got Edison at the bottom and say you got reverb and stuff like that, it will record the reverb and everything into Edison and you cannot remove it. So make sure Edison is always the first plug, the first effect on your chain, or else it will record everything behind it. So if you want to record with all, say you want to record with auto and all that, put all that stuff in front of it. So it'll just record the dry vocals just in case you want to go back and add reverb and stuff like that. So do keep that in mind when you are doing that. Okay. Just saying, because I know it used to kill me a lot, but it helped. But like I said, once you hit play.
Yes, yeah, your boy.
Oh, didn't do it right. Let's go to. Didn't do it. Mute that. We don't need that. All right. Let's cut that. Sorry about that. And then, like I said, all I gotta do is hit play now, and I don't have to. I just hit play up here, and it'll automatically start recording. Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Slim, aka Mr. Different. Not motivated by the money, but like, comment, subscribe, and views. And with that being said, y'all know what it is, and let's just keep it moving and not stop. And there you go. You got your recording. Yes, gonna say song jump because it's basically gonna play back, but you ain't gotta worry about that. You can delete those markers. All you just hit record to stop it. You can delete those markers. You don't really need those. And now to get this audio clip into your DAW or into the playlist, you just drag it over here with that drag button. Boom. And there you go. And like I said, you can put it on a channel 3 or whatever. And there you go. Oh, and we got to boop, boop, boop. Go to the mixer channel. Make sure the mixer is... turn it off, and then want to link it back up there. There you go. Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Slim, aka Mr. Different. Not motivated by the money, but like, comment, subscribe, and views. And with that being said, y'all know what it is, and let's just keep it moving and not stop. So there you go. Two ways to record inside of FL Studio. You record into the playlist or you can record through Edison. Doesn't really matter which one you use. Each one has its cons and pros, and each one has a different workflow to it. Like I said, I prefer the playlist, but some people may prefer Edison instead. Because with Edison, you can kind of do some minute stuff like fades and cut out stuff you don't want and stuff like that if you so desire. But you can always send it to Edison anyway in the if you want to do that too, so you don't have to use Edison. So hope you guys learned something. Like I said, this is how I record in FL Studio. Hope you guys learned something a little bit. And if you got any more questions on anything else I can do for you guys, please let me know and I'll make sure I get it. Gonna be gone this weekend, but hopefully when I get back I have a bunch of stuff because I'm going out of town for some family stuff. So hope you guys enjoy, have a good one, and I will see you guys in the next video. Have a good one, everybody.